Welcome to Atlas Copco Experience Studio in Sickla, a place where you can experience the cutting-edge solutions of today and discuss the sustainable manufacturing of tomorrow. My name is Amanda Teir, and I am the host of Momentum Talks, a show about smart factories. Now, let's get this show on the road. Products and vehicles are becoming more and more computerized, and this is also true for manufacturing. But an integrated production not only adds greater flexibility, higher efficiency, and sustainability, it also opens the door to new cyber threats. Is it possible to deepen digitalization while also securing a smart factory's uptime, technical knowledge, and ultimately human safety? Let's discuss. Robert Karlsson and Klas, Albons, warm welcome to Momentum Talks.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Let's start with you, Robert. I know that you are passionate about helping industrial companies become more digitalized, but what is the main benefits for them in this?
Absolutely, Amanda. It's really exciting times for the manufacturing industry right now with the move towards and into the smart factories. And I think the benefits of this digitalization are quite many. We can improve productivity by basically making real-time adjustments to the production. We can reduce the number of defects by closer integration to quality systems. And we can also increase the uptime by having things like advanced preventive maintenance. And digitalization is, of course, a key support for all of this. Another important aspect to this is that all of these benefits will also help make production more sustainable, which I think is very important going forward.
I think sustainability is a key element for everyone right now.
Absolutely.
Would you say that flexible production is something that your customers value highly?
Yes. The need for flexibility or flexible production is one of the key trends or needs that we see with our customers right now. And this is really about the factories being able to switch what they produce very quickly or produce even more variants on the same production lines. One example from the car industry would be internal combustion engines and EV vehicles on the same production line. And this also drives the need for a more flexible type of automation. And here also digitalization then, or the digital tools that are there, is a key component in making that work. And it's not so much flexibility anymore. It's more, I would say, hyper-flexibility, because flexibility has been there for a long time in the industry, but it's really in overdrive right now.
If this is some of the benefits, do you see any apparent risks in increased digitalization?
Of course. I mean, the more software we use and the more connections we have, the more exposed the factory environment becomes to things like cyber attacks and so on, so digital threats. And I think that's a challenge that, of course, needs to be overcome. But the benefit that comes out of the digitalization are really overwhelming, right? So there's really no stopping here or going backwards. The only sustainable way, I would say, is forward here.
That sounds very inspiring.
Absolutely.
So the demands for hyperflexibility and sustainability requires a more integrated manufacturing. But what is actually the difference when securing a smart factory as opposed to a traditional one? Could you please tell us a bit about these differences, Klas?
Sure, absolutely. Well, I think there are many aspects to consider. But if we start by looking at the security landscape and how it's developed, in the past we used to see one device or a few devices being attacked. Then that gradually moved into many devices and then to systems and many systems. So when we are converging or when we're connecting IT and OT, we've seen the shift from attackers that they've started to focus on the OT space and the operational environment.
So the convergence of IT and OT seems to be an important theme here. But what is actually OT?
Sure. Yep. Sorry. So IT is information technology, OT operational technology. So there are many definitions of OT and what it is, but I think we can look at OT as any device or system that supports operational processes. So the devices in operation.
And why is this IT-OT convergence so important?
Well, so the convergence gives a ton of benefits, like Robert mentioned. The ability to collect, transport, analyze data. So by connecting the two, we get a lot of additional value. We're able to create, for example, digital twins of our factories.
So if those are some of the benefits, do you see any apparent risks with the IT-OT convergence?
Sure. So while there are many benefits, of course, integrating the two opens up the attack surface. And we see especially that when older OT systems are connected as well.
And so how does this convergence influence the two systems?
Well, so within IT, I think we are more used to change, and changes have had less operational impact. Within OT, we are less subject to change. We want to standardize things, and the changes that we do make have more operational impact. So now that the two are converging, we see the OT way of working propagating into IT. So I think overall, we need to address how we make changes and keep systems up to date.
So, as a quick summary, the main difference between securing a smart factory as opposed to a traditional one would be that you have to consider both the IT and the OT systems.
Absolutely, yes.
Perfect. Then thank you to both of you, and we will get back to you later on in this episode. We have learned that a deeper digitalization is necessary for a more sustainable production. And in order to ensure the security of this new digitalized environment, we need both IT and OT security. Now let's take a closer look at OT security and how the attack vectors differ. Warm welcome to Ludwig Seitz, OT security expert. Could you please help us shed some light on this?
Thank you, Amanda. Yes. So let's compare IT and OT security incidents. In an IT security event, you might have disclosure of sensitive data. You might have corruption of digital data, and you might have downtime of your business systems. On the other hand, in an OT environment, a cyber attack could lead to downtime of your production systems. It could lead to damage to your equipment. And in the worst case, it could actually lead to harm and injury to your operators or to people around your manufacturing equipment.
So OT security actually affects human safety in production.
Yes.
I did not know that. If we try to get a little bit more hands-on, what would you consider the most important measures to take when setting up cybersecurity in an OT environment?
I would summarize that in three categories: people, process, and technology. Where people, you would be looking at increasing the security awareness of your OT workforce and the OT awareness of your IT people so that they can work together better. Process is about setting roles and responsibilities and defining how to execute your security processes, like, for example, incident response. And technology is about setting up protective technologies like antivirus programs, firewalls, or network monitoring. On a higher level, these are the same measures as in IT security. The differences come in the details of their implementation.
So when you speak about people, I mean, we have people in the IT department and people in the OT department. How do you work to get good collaboration between the two when it comes to cybersecurity?
Good collaboration is indeed very important. So one thing is that it's very important to make them understand their respective ways of working so that they can meet each other on individual terms. And when you're implementing security measures in an OT environment, it's also very important to make the operators understand the risks and threats you're trying to address so that you increase the acceptance for these measures. And finally, I would recommend to form mixed teams of IT and OT experts in order to increase the information exchange and boost mutual understanding.
And when you speak about risks, I've heard that patching is sometimes postponed in order to avoid production downtime. But aren't patches crucial to operation safety and in turn then production uptime?
Yes, indeed. Patches are very important because they reduce the vulnerabilities that actually can make cyber attacks possible. But if you do apply patches carelessly in an OT environment, that might lead to downtime itself. So what you want to do is to implement a test environment where you can test your patches and see their effect on production without affecting the actual production. And here, the smart factory actually helps because it collects the data necessary to build such test environments.
That's a great tip. I was wondering, is there any type of framework that can guide you around setting up the cybersecurity of a smart factory?
Yes, there is. The 6443 series of standards is a very good guideline for requirements and processes of OT security. And it's a very holistic framework that covers all the aspects of OT security and also bridges the gap into IT.
Well, on that note, I would like to thank you so much, Ludwig, for joining us today and for giving us so many interesting tips when it comes to OT security.
Thank you, Amanda.
Okay, so now we know a bit more about how to think when it comes to security in OT, and we also know that there are guiding standards to help. But Klas, I suppose that some of your clients might want to know what is the right level of security for them in their specific operations.
Absolutely. So we see our customers assessing both the risk and the threat landscape out there and trying to identify the right level of security for them. Of course, other than the general risks and the general threat landscape, there are other areas in the infrastructure where security controls can be implemented to mitigate the risk.
How would you say that standards help in this work?
Well, so I think the IEC 62443 standard is very good at this. It clearly defines different levels for cybersecurity. So we go all the way from level zero, where there are very few security controls, up to level four, which is the highest level, where security is really a key priority. And level four is for companies, for example, organizations within the energy sector, the defense sector, or perhaps healthcare. And a level four is suitable if you are to fend off very, very advanced and serious actors, advanced persistent threats or nation states.
Okay. And how does Atlas Copco, as a supplier and partner to manufacturing operations, work with these areas?
Well, so as a partner to our customer, we need to understand what the different needs are and the challenges are today. And I think we need to work together to further strengthen cybersecurity. Within our own organization, we work with having the right policies in place, having the right processes in place, having a high level of awareness within the organization with our employees. But then also to have the right technology in place to identify any potential issue early.
Okay, it sounds like you have some challenging but exciting work ahead of you.
Yes, indeed.
So let's have a look at what the integration and deeper digitalization means for the software in IT and OT. Robert, as an assembly partner, what software do you provide for your customers?
Well, Amanda, I think software is really at the heart of digitalization. At Atlas Copco, we have a long history as an industrial equipment provider. But today, most of the things that we do have a very strong software component to it. In the area that I work in, we provide software for our tightening controllers, which then drive our tools and ensure they provide the right parameters for a tightening application and then ships the data back out. But we also have a pure software portfolio where we have applications for analytics and insights, for managing the device configurations, for error proofing and for quality assurance.
Okay, so that's quite a lot of software, but what are the demands on software in a smart factory?
Well, we've been sending data from our devices for the last 25 years or so. But I would say the key difference now, or the key shift now, is that data is now used in much more of a real-time way, with real-time insights from the data and using it to affect changes on the production line also in real-time. So more communication between devices or also higher up centrally with central applications in the network.
And what does this increased demand on communication between software look like more in detail?
It used to be that more of a pyramid model. So our device is then sitting at the bottom of that pyramid, sending the data to one overlying device. And in the smart factory, it's generally more of a network model where devices can speak to other devices, but can also speak to software systems that are sitting quite high up in the infrastructure or even on different sites and so on. So it's much more of a connected network than it is a pyramid. For us, of course, that means other demands on how we send that data. Things like the protocols that carry the data needs to be more secure than before.
And do you have any other overall tips when it comes to securing a smart factory?
On the technical side, of course, securing the outline shell, so to speak. So things like network segmentation and things like this, of course, is very important to make sure nobody can get in. But overall, it's about collaboration, really. So make sure to discuss and take help from your partner network, from your vendors, and make sure to involve both IT and OT, because I think the perspectives are a bit different there, and the language you speak is also quite different. So it's important to collaborate tightly and decide on these solutions together. I mean, that's how we get the best sustainable solutions.
Okay, well, on this collaborative note, I feel comfortable ending this episode of Momentum Talks. Thank you so much, Robert, and thank you so much, Klas, for joining us today and sharing your insights on cybersecurity and smart factories.
Thank you, Amanda.
Thank you very much.
We live in exciting manufacturing times. The entire production is becoming integrated. While this brings opportunities for more sustainable production, it also brings new cyber threats. In today's episode of Momentum Talks, we spoke with experts in IT, OT, and software. And we identified 7 tips for a more cybersecure smart factory. Don't wait with deeper digitalization. It is the sustainable way forward. IT and OT differ. Raise overall OT awareness. Always keep updated on new types of cyber threats. Set up a test environment for regular OT patches. Use industry standards as a framework for cybersecurity. Estimate your operation's security level. And finally, collaborate closely between IT and OT departments.